Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to revise the first lesson of science, that is our earth and our solar system. So children, in this we have seen that when we stand on an open ground and when we look up into the sky, then we can see the sky. Yes, and if it is a clear night, children, we can see many stars. So you may have a fill in the blank like, in a clear night sky we see many dash. What is that? Many stars. And all these stars, whatever we see in the sky, are very very far away from us. Okay, and some of them are prominent while some of them are tiny and faint. Now the next thing what we had studied in this lesson, that is the sun and the moon are comparatively close to the earth. If we will compare other heavenly bodies, compare to them, then sun and the moon are more close to the earth compared to others, and thus we are able to see their round shape. Now you may also have a question like, what are heavenly bodies? Or you can have like a fill in the blank. So the sun, the moon, the stars, the planets, etc. are all known as heavenly bodies. Next, now let us study each one of them in detail. So first heavenly body what we are going to study, that is star. So the heavenly bodies that twinkle are called stars. Okay, so you can say that the heavenly body that twinkle are called dash. What will be the answer? Stars. Stars have their own light. Now the biggest star is the sun. Okay, so sun is a star. Why? Because we have just learned that stars have their own light. And students, we all know that sun is also having its own light. So the sun is a star. Next, it is closer to us, means it is closer to the earth, and thus it appears very big. Okay, if you will compare other stars in the heavenly body or in the space, if you will consider other stars, or then compared to them, the sun is closer to the earth, and thus it appears big and brilliant. Means like a fire ball it appears. And thus when it is present in the daytime in the sky, we are unable to see other stars. Now let us study about the next heavenly body, that is planets. So see students, the heavenly body that do not twinkle are called planets. Now if they don't twinkle, that means they do not have their own light. So always remember, planets do not have their own light, and thus they do not twinkle. Now from whom do they get light? They get light from the stars. Okay, from whom do they get light? They get light from the stars. Okay, now next important thing about planets, that is planets revolve around a star, and also they rotate around themselves. Now suppose this is a sun. I'll use yellow color and this is the sun. And I'll draw one blue color circle which will represent our earth. So this is our earth. And now suppose this earth is moving in this way around the sun, then this motion of earth is called revolution. Earth is planet and sun is star. So children, always remember, planets revolve around stars, and they also move on their own place. They turn on their own place, and that motion is called as rotation. Okay, now let us study about the solar system. Just now we have revised that our earth is a planet and it is getting light from the sun. and it also moves around the sun. Yes or no? What is that motion called? Yes, its movement around, Earth's movement around the sun is called revolution of the Earth. Now see children, there are total 7 planets which revolve around the sun. They are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. So these are our planets. Got it? Now, so remember that every planet in our solar system rotates around the sun. Yeah, and when they are revolving, they have their specific path, and that specific path of the planets is called as planet's orbit. Now, what is solar system? The sun, which is a star, the planets that are revolving together form or together is called solar system. So besides the planet, the solar system includes various other heavenly bodies. Now let us study about them in detail. So the other heavenly bodies in the solar system, in that the first one is satellite. So listen students, what is satellite? Some heavenly bodies revolve around planets. These are called satellites. Satellites too get their light from the sun. Okay, satellite don't have their own light, they get their light from sun. So at the night time, the moon, you are able to see the moon. Yes, it is the satellite of the Earth. And why we are able to see it? Because it is revolving around the Earth. See, moon is the satellite of the Earth. Are you getting? Next thing that is, most of the planets in our solar system have dash. What will be the answer? Yes, the answer will be satellite. Okay, now we have learned that the planets revolve around the sun along with their satellites. So as the planets are revolving, I showed you before, and side to that planets, they have their satellites, and their satellites also revolve with the planets. Next, that is the dwarf planets. So there are some heavenly bodies which are smaller, and that too are revolving around the sun, and that heavenly bodies which are small in size are called as dwarf planets. So the most well-known dwarf planet is Pluto. So you may have fill in the blank like dash is a dwarf planet. What is the answer? Pluto, or Pluto is dash planet, dwarf. Okay, so these planets, dwarf planets, when they are revolving, they also have their own orbit. Next heavenly bodies, that is asteroids. So see here, what are asteroids? There is a band of numerous heavenly bodies. Okay, means many heavenly bodies are there together, and they lie between the planet Mars and Jupiter. And that band of numerous heavenly body is called as asteroids. Okay, and these asteroids also revolve around the sun. So compared to the sun, other heavenly bodies in the solar system are much dash. What will be the answer? Smaller. Okay, now among the sun, the moon, which is closer to the earth? The answer will be the moon. Compared with the sun and the moon, among these two, the moon is closest to the earth. That is why it appears to be big, although it is very small. Sun is very big compared to moon. But when we see in the sky, during the day we can see sun and during night we can see moon. But we can see moon bigger than the sun, isn't it? It is because moon is closer to the earth. Now, thus, you can also have question like, the planets, the satellites, dwarf planets and dash are an part of the solar system. What will be the answer? Asteroids. Or you can have the question like, the planets, satellite, dwarf planets and asteroids are all part of the dash. What will be the answer? The solar system. Got it? So now let's move on to the further part of the lesson, that is gravity. So see, when you throw anything high up in the sky, like ball, or you might have seen the fruits falling. Yes? Have you ever seen the fruit going up high into the sky? Never. When the fruit is completely ripe, it falls down on the earth. Yes or no? Means on the land. Yes? Even when you throw ball high up into the sky, after certain distance, that ball also comes down. Is because of force of gravity. So what is force of gravity? Heavenly bodies exert a force of attraction or pull on one another. This force is called force of gravity. Means the earth is exerting a gravitational pull on all the planets. Like that only, planets have their tendency to move away from the sun. And thus, both these forces, because of both of them, the planets keep revolving around the sun and they are revolving at fixed orbit. In the same way, there is force of attraction or force of gravity among the satellites and around their planets. Okay, now the next thing what we are going to revise, that is, so you can have a question like, people have also been curious about the dash in the sky, and what will be the answer? Heavenly bodies. Okay, so next thing, like, dash technology or space launch technology is used against the force of gravity. Then which technology? Rocket technology. Okay. Then the explosive burns rapidly and produces lot of energy. So, if you want to send the spacecraft, you can see it in the picture. If you want to send the spacecraft in the sky or in the space, then how will you send it? Yes, you require very powerful rocket. So, the fill in the blank may be like, dash are used to send spacecraft into space. Answer will be very powerful rockets. Then there may be question like, in the dash century, a few countries of the world developed space technology and sent hundreds of spacecraft into space. Which century? 20th century. So what happens when we send this spacecraft? Sometimes some of the spacecraft remain in the space while some are brought back to the earth. That means they are brought back on the earth or land, while some land on other planets or satellites. And in this mission we have many scientists who travel from that. Okay. And what are these scientists called as? Yes, they are called as astronauts. So you may have a question like, scientists traveling from the spacecraft or from in the spacecraft are called as. What are those called as? Astronauts. Okay. Now, we all are familiar with Rakesh Sharma. Yes, many of you may be knowing. Who is Rakesh Sharma? Yes, pay attention carefully. Rakesh Sharma was first Indian astronaut to go into the space. And in which year did he go into the space? In 1984. Okay, so question may be, dash year Rakesh Sharma went into the space. That the answer will be 1984. Or you may also have question like this. Dash became the first Indian astronaut. Who is that to go into the space? Rakesh Sharma. So how many days did he spend in that mission? 8 days. Okay. See, he spent 8 days on a space station for joint mission of the ISRO and the Soviet Intercosmos. And from there, when he saw the Earth, what did he say? Yes, he said, Sare jahan se achha. Means, it's very beautiful among whole world. So next you may have question like, when was Chandrayaan 1 launched? Then the answer will be 22nd October 2008. Okay. So on 22nd October 2008, the Indian Space Research Organization, that is ISRO, had launched a spacecraft to the moon. And that mission is called as Chandrayaan. Okay. 1. Next, which is another important Indian space mission? Mangalyaan. And what is it known as? MOM, that is Mars Orbit Mission. Next, when was it launched? Yes, it was launched on 5th November 2013. And it got established in an orbit around the planet Mars. So, when was it established? On 24th September 2014. Getting? And see, ISRO achieved these feats in its first attempt. Both these missions are unmanned, that is, they're manned, that is, there were no people on board this spacecraft. Okay? So, like this, objective questions you may have for your test. One more thing what we are going to revise, that is about man-made satellites. So, man-made satellites are used for dash. What is that? Yes, they are used for telecommunication. Which informations do we get from man-made satellites? Information for agriculture, environment, weather forecasting, making maps, searching for water and mineral, etc. Okay, now the next thing what we are going to revise, that is, always remember. So, our Earth is an dash planet. How is our Earth? Yes, it is an invaluable planet. Okay, next. So what is there, what we have learned? There are points. So on that, you can have things on the Earth remain on it due to the force of dash. What will be the answer? Gravity. Okay, so like this, objective question like true or false also you may have, like that answers you will have. Like the Sun is a planet, what will be the true or false? False. Okay, like this question, whatever points I have revised, go through that. Based on that, you will have questions. Okay, so I have revised whole lesson. Number one, go through the video, listen it carefully, and be prepared for your test.